All right, welcome to the video. I'm trying out a new concept here. Prime time broadcasting, as it were. Trying to make it available to people on different time zones, especially the Eastern time zone. It's right now, it's a 5:30 out on the West Coast. And it's the 9th of August, 2012. I've been saying to not watch the Olympics, don't watch television. I have something else to add to that. And it's came about last several days. I've been feeling some pressure to do a documentary on Ananda Maima, and I keep saying no. I've been there, done that. It's not really the right thing to do, and something keeps pressuring me. So I'm spending so much time searching on YouTube, searching on the internet for material I can use. And as I'm doing that, I keep falling asleep. I'll be there at the keyboard, and before I know it, I wake up and I realize I had dropped off to sleep just like that. And as I came awake, I had an awareness of what was happening while I was asleep, and some purposeful activity, getting directions saying, you need to do this. By a lookalike of Ananda Maima, long, straight, dark hair. And again and again, I kept having this. Every time I went to sleep, this lady showed up, and she's trying to direct me and tell me what to do. And it's not right. It's not good. This is what I call a psychic double, a facsimile, a fake. Okay, that is being used by the reptilians, or the etheric vampires, as it were. Those are the ones who are trying to turn the planet into a slave planet to supply their what they need from us. And they're trying to get me to waste my time in this way, and misdirect, and actually provide them with some leverage that they want. But beyond that, I realized that the high technology, the internet, is a mind control. It offers these etheric vampires a means of mind control, a means of accessing us and pulling us into their plans. Very, very wicked thing. As is television, as are movies. But the internet is also extremely effective mind control tool that these beings that dwell in the etheric realm, as it were, in between the astral and the dense physical here, and who are trying to use the physical density to support their kingdom, the etheric kingdom that they're in, and maintain it. And they need us to be like slaves, like cows producing milk for them, that we produce certain emanations when our glands and our system is activated in various ways, with passion and emotion and violence and all fear, all this stuff. It creates an energy swirl, as it were, in the etheric. The etheric interpenetrates our bodies, and so when that passion and emotionalism is activated, it generates an enormous energy source for them, literally somehow maintaining their realm, as it were. And they need more and more and more of this maintenance to prevent their world, their domain, from decaying and disintegrating, as everything does in existence. Energy, the purpose of existence is self-destructive, is to for existence to destroy itself. So of course decay and death and all of that are the very purpose of it. And the utopianists, who are trying to establish some kind of parity in the realm of energy, which is impossible, and in order to do this, they have to work towards enslavement. And in order to try to accomplish this, they work towards enslavement and trying to get others to supply certain types of energy that they need to try and protect their domain from abnormal, you know, quick decay, disintegration, and all that stuff. And so there is this enormous battle going on between in the subtle plane, just behind the physical. When I lost consciousness on the physical. Immediately, I was aware of this etheric realm and what was going on there, and that they're using the internet and our attention on it to put us in a certain state of mind, that they're able to influence us that way very, very powerfully. And I said, no, I'm not doing that documentary. And they say, well, you don't want to do a documentary on your guru? I said, I already have done that, spent years and years and years, but it all actually ended up very badly for me, wasted my time, and led me down very bad roads. And because it was not Ananda Mayama that was asking me to do this documentary work, it was the fake facsimile guru that the etheric vampires use. They know all the teachers and gurus in this world. They know the ones we trust the most, and then they make these fake facsimiles of it that look like them. They try to make a double, as it were, and then use this double as like a puppet, and then tell you, they use the puppet as if the puppet were speaking of this guru, the double, and then tell you that they want you to do this and this and this and this, and that will be extremely helpful, it's going to save everybody, etc. But what you're really doing is you're helping the etheric vampires when you go in that direction. See, I don't think Ananda Mayama has ever asked me to do anything, and yet I spent an incredible amount of time, maybe, 5 years straight, trying to produce documentaries and picture collections and all sorts of work, and that's continued on, and I realized that is not the right thing to do. It's not the right thing to do. So these etheric vampires are very clever at what they do, and they have no conscience. I can't believe that they would take the most trusted figures that have appeared in this world, make doubles out of them, etheric psychic doubles, and use those doubles to deceive us and mislead us. That is, to us, that is simply, no shame, no shame whatsoever. Kind of sounds like the politicians of the day, right? No shame. They're willing to do anything because they're working for these psychic vampires. And when I say vampires, parasites, they live off of our energy. And you ever wonder why the movies and the television are saturated with the sex and violence? And it's because that is what the psychic vampires want us to be reacting to, because it produces... it's like throwing a stone, and it produces these massive ripples, these massive vibrations in the ether, in the etheric realm, and they're able to use that, capture it as very powerful energy, somehow to stabilize their system. They use it to stabilize their system. It's like it produces clouds, like we would say here, it produces clouds that bring rain, right, so to speak. So all these, violent, passionate emotions that we're having, is like creates, like, as it were, etheric clouds that produce sort of rain that, stabilizes, that brings, enables the whole system to keep on going, and they're able to pursue this utopian dream of trying to create a separate reality. And but their purpose is to enslave the whole planet, is to have everybody simply like cattle sitting in front of their television sets with their remote control and all their little gadgets, etc., and constantly being fed this extremely wicked, violent, terrifying stuff, which with the movies and television alike, and also these emotional stuff where people are screaming and crying and just producing all these emotional reactions, and then all the pornography that is absolutely inundated the planet. That's also what they're doing. That's part of their plan, and just keep everybody saturated in this cycle of producing this energy form. And they want everybody to be doing that for them. That is their plan. That is what they're trying to do. And they've gone a long, long ways towards that. And they're fighting for that. And they're willing to use these fake gurus, these doubles, as it were. And we see them, they say, that looks very similar, I said, wow, that looks like Ananda Mayama. And she's speaking to me, she's saying, I want you to do this, 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 and this. And I think, wow, she's saying this will help enlighten everyone and save them. So I think it's the right thing to do. But my intuition is saying, no, don't do that. That'll cause very bad problems if you do that. Okay? So what I'm thinking is doing some prime time programming here on YouTube to give an option to people, It's a dangerous thing to simply be surfing the internet. Very dangerous thing. It's incredible. When you do that, you find yourself going from A to B to C to D to E to F, and before you know it, you know, you're looking at pictures of crocodiles or something, you know, or some you know, heavy death thrash metal stuff, or I mean, you find yourself sinking down a lot of times. It's like a trap, an entropy trap, where the thing that it's so hard to find good content on the internet. So difficult. I literally spend every evening surfing the internet looking for quality content, just so I can maybe include it here on this channel or something, or to, you know, help elevate. Say, what is there out there to elevate? And I can't find anything. It is so bizarre. There are a few areas that have a little bit of sputtering, you know, to it, like, but not really elevated. Not escape velocity. You need escape velocity from these psychic vampires, these etheric parasites, okay? Because they have been at this a long time, and they view us as their cattle. They think they own us. You know, they believe they have ownership of us. And they've been very successful at what they're doing, enabling themselves to trick us, really to trick us into giving them consent to do what they're doing, because they claim that they're doing what they're doing out of our consent. Well, if you make false promises, you can get consent out of false promises, can you not? That's what they did to me. They made false promises. They used deception. They used doubles that were not the true being that they said they were. And they used my own desire to help, my own compassion, to trick me and all this stuff. So that is not really true consent at all, because it's consent gained on a fraudulent basis. So I would say to you, all consent you've ever given these etheric parasites is null and void. It's been null and void since the very beginning. And certainly the Prime Creator doesn't hold you to that. Your spirit doesn't hold you to that. There's nothing that holds you to that. And the idea is that breaking some promise or something. No. Hold on a second. How can you say that you made a promise if the promise was procured under false pretenses? You cannot. That's not a promise. Okay, so these etheric parasites, these reptilian psychic vampires who are extracting the energy, they use us, they keep us in this stimulated state, and that stimulated state produces the energy that they need to maintain and stabilize their kingdom and their functioning. They're using the so-called our consent for this, as if, you know, we had consented. We never consented to that. They lied to us about everything. They've certainly gained the consent of the world here, but it was under false pretenses. So what we need to do is we need to drop that consent. It's null and void. In fact, it was null and void from the very beginning. Okay. So this is the kind of talk you don't hear. I can't find it on the internet. I can't find it anywhere. I can't find it in books. There are some people who are doing some pretty good work, but they don't have escape velocity. And I'm just telling it like it is. What I say here has a little more escape velocity. I'd like to up it even more, if I can, and I'm trying to. And just for instance, all contracts, all promises, all contracts are null and void. Okay, with any of these in any way, you can take it further. All contracts in existence itself are null and void, because existence itself was entered into under a false promise that we could achieve the goal of changing reality, which we cannot. So the whole thing, all promises in existence are null and void. All contracts are null and void. All of them entered into under false pretenses. If you can accept this and see it, you start getting escape velocity. Okay, escape velocity. Escaping from this trap here that is trying to turn us all into cattle to be endlessly milked, you know, and then slaughtered for our meat, as it were. It's an absolutely horrible. And in order to maintain their decaying, disintegrating fantasy land, they have to produce more and more and more stimulation here, of more and more violent and what do you call it, violent, erotic, sort of a combination of the two, which presents the most severe stimulation. They did this in Roman times too. They mixed the two of sex and violence. The mixture of those two produces the strongest kind of emanations that they use. And in the Roman times, they you know, let's be perfectly direct here. They used literally the slaughter of people, and at the same time, these people were engaged in orgies at the same time, and they used the death, actually death of people, to stimulate themselves sexually in orgies, and this produced this extreme energy. They used human sacrifice. They did all this stuff, and all this stuff is coming back from the Roman Empire right now. It's incredibly wicked. So before people criticize Christianity and the other religions too much, keep in mind that they were what led us out of that nightmare. Okay, where the reptilians, the psychic parasites, had the world in their clutches and were driving the world to engage in horrible, horrible wars and emotionalism and violence and stuff. And Jesus Christ came in the world and said, look, there's a way out. And he gave us the keys, you know, a set of keys to get out. Agree with your adversary. Love your enemy. Turn the other cheek. You know, practice the utmost morality, you know, in thought and deed. And all sorts of various teachings which turned us away from the control of these parasites and enabled us to begin to figure out how to escape them altogether, which is ultimately escaping existence altogether. So these etheric parasites have been engaged in a war against religion, especially Christianity, and especially the United States, which is the strongest bastion of Christianity, to destroy it, because this has stood in their way. It's been an obstacle. It's been a thorn in their side, because people under these guidelines are not producing the kind of stimulation that they require to produce effects in the etheric realm where they are dwelling, and so they hate it. I mean, they feel like they're being starved. You know, their mortal enemy. Christianity is their mortal enemy, really, and other religions too. But Christianity especially gave out the keys to escape, how to escape the situation. And I have been studying that, how to escape the situation, because that's pretty much the question on everyone's mind. How do we escape this? You know, and that is the crucial part, and that's the part that I have focused on. I'm aware of all the others, but I don't emphasize the details of all the mischief and wickedness that these etheric vampires are engaged in, because it's really off the charts and never ending. They are simply, there are no rules. They don't play by any rules, as it were. They will tell any lie. They will do anything to try and maintain their position in existence, because they feel anything other than that is annihilation, which is wrong. You know, they're deluded. They're entirely deluded, and they will do anything. So, I mean, you know, talking about all that kind of waste some time if you get into it too much, because what we really need to be focusing on is how to get free of it. But it is important at least to acknowledge the severity of the situation right now, because it truly is extremely severe, and there is no political solution to this at all. You know, even though some of you, you know, out there may not want to hear, you know, because it's such a PC thing to say religion's terrible, right? So PC, it's so intellectual to say that, like as if you're some kind of intellectual elite, like, oh yeah, you know, religion's terrible. It's not, that is not being an intellectual elite. That's being a fake elite. Because if you really understand the big picture, you will know that the religious precepts that have been given out are protection from that. And they really, seen properly, give you the escape from it. And that is very, very true. But in the climate of today, you know, of just like demonizing religion, who's doing that really? I'm not. Of course they're fools in religion. Of course they're fools. Of course it's been twisted. Of course. All that's normal. That's par for the course here. That doesn't mean that at the root, it's still there's still the right teaching is there. Absolutely it is. If you can see it, it's not easy to see. But the constant demonization of it has led people to drop their guard and feel like they got nowhere to turn. You know, where do I turn? And that's the bad situation, is people don't know where to turn right now. And so I'm providing this here as a service to the world to help you see where to turn. Don't throw the baby out with the bathwater. Sure, realize that there's a lot of foolishness in religion, okay? But the demons, the psychic parasites, take that foolishness and try to cover the whole picture with that and say, you know, this is what you must stand for. And if you stand for this, you must be an intellectual lightweight, okay? But the real heavyweights, intellectual heavyweights, see through that sham as well. And they say, yeah, there's foolishness. But it's even more foolish to take that foolishness and paint the whole situation as foolish and then try to say that you're intellectually inferior if you somehow go for it. That is even worse. That is even more disingenuous. It is even a weaker show of intellectual clarity. The truth is that the education on this planet is not education, it's indoctrination. Okay, there is no education here. I saw that very early on and I just dropped out. I said, there's no education. This is 100% indoctrination. 100%. Everything they were telling me was a lie because I knew it. Every last darn thing was a lie. And I said, they're just indoctrination. So that's it. Seventh grade, I said, that's it. Didn't pay any more attention to that, to what's going on. So you have a vast number of people now who have been indoctrinated into a false notion of intellectual integrity. And they think, and deep down they feel their foundation is not stable. And so these parasites, these etheric parasites, tell them, here's how you stabilize your intellectual integrity by dumping on, you know, religion and conspiracy people and all those kind of, you know, people they call kooks or nuts or whatever you want to call them. And they think they're solidifying their, you know, intellectual gravitas by rejecting and demonizing these folks. Whereas, in a matter of fact, they're merely giving expression to their lack of intellectual integrity and clarity, and the fact that they have been indoctrinated. That is what they're really expressing, as their own indoctrination into a severe naivete. I mean, they deny even the fact that there are these etheric parasites, these psychic vampires, these reptilian vampires, as it were. They deny that there's any such thing. Anyone says such a thing, they must be completely insane. I mean, that's how disingenuous and naive they are. You know, the wiser you are, the more you see the big picture here, and you realize that this has been going on for a long time. This struggle, this battle here on this earth between people here and those in the slightly subtler realms, trying to exploit and use people here, use our energy, as it were. And that's why Christianity has emphasized a civil society, okay? That is extremely important. Extremely important. I try to be very civil here. I don't always, you know, feel that way, but even if you don't feel that way, you should always try to be very loving, kind, and civil, even to your enemies, so to speak, even to those who are naive and trying to enslave you to etheric parasites. Even those, you should be still civil and kind, because that is very important. Otherwise, things deteriorate into hate, deteriorate into this confused, horrible morass. And then people feel so desperate to feel better about themselves, they become very vulnerable to pornography and violence and all this stuff that kind of stimulates them, makes them feel more powerful, as it were. It's a wicked, wicked, vicious spiral. Okay, negative spiral that we're caught up in this world. And the lack of civility in this world right now is absolutely shocking. Absolutely shocking. People that still have it, I was addressed by someone who comes from old tradition, and they, they say something like "kind sir," or "respected sir," something like that. "Respected sir," something like that. You know, that's how it's supposed to be done. That's how it's supposed to be done. And these politicians are fanning the flames of incivility and hatred, and that's exactly what the reptilians want, exactly what they want. And so they're under the control. They are under the control because they themselves are intellectual lightweights and are desperate to attain some sort of status in the eyes of these etheric parasites, because they know they're phonies. Deep down, they know they're phonies. Okay, I know I've done the work, so I don't have to kowtow and try to gain some sort of status with these reptilians, etc. Because I know I've done the work, okay? I know what I'm talking about. I don't need them to praise me, okay? Don't need their praise because they're way more ignorant than I am. So why should I, you know, seek their praise, as it were? You know, they don't have any idea of the illusory nature of existence, what existence is. They're naive, they're ignorant, they're just desperately trying to create a utopia. Anytime you get a utopian who's trying to bring about a utopia within existence, within the field of energy, they are extremely deluded and extremely dangerous. Dangerous is to pull you into that naivete and use your energy, suck you dry of all your energy and leave you desiccated. They will do that. They will absolutely do that. And they'll leave you as a corpse after sucking you dry of everything. Preying off your naivete, off your laziness, okay? You cannot afford to be lazy in this world. You cannot afford it. You cannot afford to be without a true religious education here. You cannot. You cannot. So what I did is I saw the indoctrination of education. I said, wow, they're not giving me the proper education. They're giving me indoctrination, and they're insisting that I be naive, extremely naive and vulnerable. And I said, forget it. So then I gave myself a religious education, a proper education, under the guidance of the Holy Spirit, the inner voice of reason. And I came across right teachers and helpful teachers, and had to give myself the proper religious education. And having that now, I'm not intimidated or afraid to speak out and say these things because it's just, you know, why? You know, time doesn't outlast eternity. All their bluffs are about the power they're going to get when they outlast eternity, outlast endlessness, which will never happen. You know, they say when they gain all power, you know, and then the new creators, they're going to snuff out anybody who opposed them, you know. Never, it will never happen. So it's a bluff. It's absolutely a bluff. Time is just bluffing. Okay, anything in time is merely a bluff. And I know a lot of you have had to undertake your own religious spiritual education on your own too. It is not easy. It is not easy in this world. But it's essential. It's essential. Absolutely essential. So what we're doing is, this is like a graduate course. You know, graduate. I'm like a, what do you call it, a graduate teacher or a student teacher for a graduate student who's helping teach this graduate course. And I'm by no means am I a true heavyweight at all, but what do you call it, an assistant teacher, yeah. Doing graduate teaching graduate students in their religious spiritual education how to attain escape velocity and the importance of it. And just the very fact that you can hear somebody standing up to these extremely deluded, those who have bought into insanity very heavily and remain so, is very refreshing and very helpful for you, because you say, aha, it can be done. It can be done. And of course, the the etheric parasites will just say, nah, he's only able to do that because he's completely insane or completely crazy, you know. At least they think that they'll be able to claim that once their plan works, which is to outlast endlessness. And that plan won't work, can never work. So they're on the losing side of the equation entirely. And, you know, eventually they'll have to get off that losing side, because nobody wins on that side. Nobody wins. No one will ever win. But they're trying. They're trying our best to, you know, to outlast endlessness. And they're just trying to keep themselves in this sort of, you know, fantasy land, pleasure palace fantasy land. And they're using our energy to, the energy that they stimulate. You know, I'll tell you this. You know how scientists have now developed treatments for cattle, for instance, to stimulate their milk production, right? You know what I'm talking about. I don't want to name names, but you know what's going on with that. All the steroids that they're giving to cattle and chicken and our food supply, all right, our whole food supply. You know, they say this milk has no, what, DBSD or something. I mean, they are stimulating the cattle to produce more milk and whatever. And of course, it's just causing, you know, terrible problems. And the milk is not good for us, et cetera, et cetera. The same thing, the etheric parasites are feeding this planet with, as it were, steroids. Pornography is like a steroid, okay? All the glossy magazines with the pictures of the models and all their various poses and attitudes, etc. You know, they all cop some sort of, you know, attitude. It's almost always death-based, harm-based, shock-based. Like, they all look like they're in some kind of, you know, deep trauma. You know, they just and they dress up in all these slinky ways, and they're all of that is like steroids that they're feeding us to stimulate us to produce more of this energy that they need, that they say they need in order to maintain their delusions. But we're not under no obligation to help them maintain their delusions. You know, they need to awaken themselves, and instead of awakening, they're using all their efforts to maintain their delusion, which is, you know, we don't have to go along with that plan. That plan is a disaster, terrible, okay? Doesn't matter what they claim. It's not true what they claim. So the movies, the television, the internet, the magazines, the advertisements, the whole modern media culture, okay, are like steroids that we are, they're psychic steroids that we are ingesting. We are all extremely strung out on these psychic steroids, extremely strung out on those. That is why I say, you know, don't watch television, don't watch. And I point out the Olympics, because a lot of people are getting sucked into watching television with the Olympics. And why, when you're watching, you're getting all these trailers for upcoming programming, right? Commercials of all types, trying to suck you into watching more television, to paying attention to this. It's a lot. It's like a way, a so-called wholesome way, to get you addicted, pulled into watching more and more television. Very bad. Very bad. And don't use this video here to suck you into watching a whole bunch more videos, you know. That's not its point. I remember Top 40 Radio, they used to have some really great songs. And they'd play those only occasionally. And they wouldn't tell you when, of course. So you'd listen all day waiting to hear that song again. That's really, really nice, positive song. In the meantime, they're feeding you all this garbage songs, right? And just absolutely sliming you with these psychic steroids of this nasty music. Music is another way, very, very powerful way, a type of psychic steroid that's being used on this planet, of extremely wicked music, very, very much designed to stimulate you in the way that these etheric parasites want you to be stimulated. Very much, 100%, very nasty stuff. If I listen to any music, I listen to old classic country, which doesn't have that. It's free of it. It's pretty much free of it. Okay. If anything, it evokes a feeling of a kind of of wanting to be free of this world, you know, like the tragedy and the loss of this world. You say, you know what, I want to go home. I really want to go home. It evokes that feeling. It doesn't give the feeling that these psychic parasites want. It doesn't stimulate you in that way. So I was guided into that, saying, listen, I got the guidance to listen to this sometimes country gospel music as in classic country, and this back in the 50s and 60s, where it was very free of this really bad psychic parasite influence. It came from Christianity, really did. And that type of music for me, it helps calm me down and doesn't give the parasites what they want. Whereas the modern music these days, holy cow, you know, I don't listen to it at all. No way, no way, no how. Music is a powerful, powerful psychic drug, a steroid, psychic steroid, powerful. And then you mix that in. What happens? They use that and mix it in with the visuals on the music videos and the award shows, and every way in the movies, every way that music is used, because music, we're very attracted to it. So they use the combination of this music and the visuals, and then they add in this really demonic type of background sound effects and horror effects that frighten us, etc. And before you know it, you know, we're like deer in headlights, allowing our endocrine system, which is finely attached to the etheric realm. Our endocrine glands, our whole subtle nervous system is intertwined with the etheric realm directly, and they're playing our glands, as it were. They're playing our reactions as we're sitting there transfixed, watching a movie. You know, our system is getting played and producing the notes, the music that they want to hear in the etheric realm. In other words, the energy patterns that they require, that they want to maintain their doped up, delusional, non-experiencing, as it were, their fantasy. It's like a drug to them, but it's more than that. It's a way of maintaining their bubble, as it were. So we're just getting played. We are getting played. Don't let yourself get played. Don't let yourself get played. You cannot zone out. Don't zone out. Don't get into anything that's got, you know, stay away from music, pretty much. So I stay away from it. I rarely listen to it anymore. It is so dangerous. So dangerous. Before you know it, it's easy to get pulled down, to get dragged down. So easy. You listen to one song and you listen to another artist. Before you know it, you're listening to some heroin addict guitar player who's just constantly, you know, hammering away at your nervous system to produce these, you know, responses that the parasites want. It's an entirely nasty situation, entirely so. And, you know, it's been outed in, you know, there's a lot of people have been outing it. I'm not the only one. And it's a collective effort. It's a collective effort. I wouldn't be able to do what I'm doing if there weren't this culture of outing this and all those people who have been doing this, Christian, non-Christian, whatever background they have, that they have been standing up to it. They've been outing it. You know, they've been rejecting it and in various, all sorts of various ways. I wouldn't be able to say what I say if it hadn't been for all those who have been doing this. It's a collective effort. And everybody who does this helps a little bit. But do not fall for the utopian idea of, well, we're going to create a utopia here in this world. That's exactly what the reptilians want you to believe. That traps you here. Jesus didn't say he's coming back to establish a kingdom here. He said, I'm coming back to take you to the place that I prepared for you, so that you can dwell there with me. He said this world is under the control of the devil, of the prince of darkness, I think he said, which is true. So he never said he's coming back here to establish a paradise on this planet. I know that's some claim that, you know, there's a golden age coming, etc. No, he said he's coming back to. He said he's leaving to prepare a place for us, and then he's going to come back and take us to that place he's prepared for us. We can dwell there with him, and which is it's the lost free realm. That is what we're entitled to. Okay, that is what we're entitled to. These etheric parasites, these reptilian vampires, want or keep feeding us this utopian ideal on this planet to keep us here, to make us think that's what we're supposed to be doing, so that then they can control us and milk us, pump us, keep us pump full of steroids, psychic steroids. That's what they want. That's what they want. Jesus never said anything to that effect. And if any, you know, of his followers said that, they were mistaken in that. It is such a ludicrous idea to think you can create a utopia on this planet. That is so insane. It is just the height of folly. You know, it's almost ridiculous to even comment about it. If there's any loss anywhere, it is not a utopia. It's not what you really want at all. Any loss, if there's any vulnerability anywhere, it is not what you really want. It is not a true utopia. Any loss. That it means if there's a single bird that, you know, falls, if there's a leaf that falls, if there's anything, any sickness, anything at all, that no matter how slight it is, that witnesses to loss or vulnerability in any way, it is not a utopia. It is not what you really want. Period. And so, the idea of advancing utopia on this planet is completely verklempt. It is the most ridiculous notion possible, literally. And those who are advancing that are literally under the control of these psychic vampires. Literally under their control, no matter how spiritual they may seem. Okay? I don't care who they are or how famous they are. They're under the control of the reptilians, the vampires, the psychic vampires who are feeding off of our energy. The whole vampire thing is a way of symbolizing these etheric parasites, how they tap into our subtle energy system and stimulate it and feed off of that, like our blood, so to speak. On this level, dense level, it symbolizes someone feeding off their blood, and they maintain their immortality, or so to speak. But the psychic vampire, the etheric vampires, they feed off of our energy reactions. As we're stimulated, our endocrine system is stimulated, they feed off of that. They use that to maintain the stability of their realm, which enables them to continue to dwell there, as it were. So they don't come down into a denser experience, which they don't want. And they use us to keep themselves from sinking into this deeper density. But actually, sinking into this deeper density is actually where you discover escape velocity. Where they're at right now, they cannot discover it, really. It's a dead end for them. When you sink down into greater density, you come to a point where you see the whole thing. You see the whole thing. And you say, oh my gosh, I see the entire delusion of existence, what it is, from the very beginning. And then you're on the path to going back home, to freedom, to the lost free realm first, and then to a full awareness of reality. And so they're trying to prevent themselves from doing that, trying to maintain this superiority complex that they have. And they use the elites of this world to do their dirty work, you know, as it were, to dumb everybody down, keep everybody controlled, all of this stuff. But the elites of this world are just pawns. They're just pawns. Empty suits, just pawns, really. So they don't want to have they don't want to sink down into deeper density, but they're desperately trying to prevent that, thinking that they'll be just, you know, the end for them, as it were. It's not. What happens is, at some point, they will make a turnaround. They'll make a turnaround, and they'll get free. Themselves will get free. But we have to let them do that. We're not here to prop up their delusions, okay? No way, no how. And so this whole notion of creating a paradise on this planet just keeps us here, so they can keep stimulating us and psychic steroiding us and milking us with all these vibrations that we give off. And as you've seen, the programming, the steroids are giving us, are becoming stronger and stronger and stronger as they become more and more desperate. And as we become more and more worn out because we're becoming exhausted, when you stimulate the physical form over and over and over and over and over, it gets depleted, more and more depleted, more and more depleted. It gets burned out, as it were. And so what do? They keep feeding us energy drinks and stimulants, okay? Coffee, caffeine, everybody's caffeinated. 90% of the women of the world are caffeinated, and maybe the men, it's 100%, I don't know. But almost all of the world is on stimulants. And then this enables you to keep going, and you get herded into the movie theater, or you go, order your DVD, and you're staring at the, your plasma or LED, LCD screen. And you're watching, the prime time, and you're watching your programs, and getting bombarded with this psychopathic programming that the reptilian parasite industry is producing here on this planet. People who are producing this are entirely under the control of these reptilian parasites. Entirely under their control, under their direction, and they're trying to please their masters with what they're doing. Because they're told they're going to be elevated themselves, and be to a higher level, so to speak. No, they're just going to be used up and discarded. And the talented ones are on all sorts of drugs, all sorts of stimulants, whatever drug it takes, they're taking it to keep producing this stuff, And then when they can't do it anymore, they OD, They OD. A lot of talented artists in this world who got used by the reptilians, they overdosed. Maybe their conscience couldn't take it anymore, Their nervous system shattered, really shattered. And they produce all this music and entertainment for us, that these steroids, psychic steroids, which stimulate us in the ways that the psychic vampires want. So this is just plain talk. Those of you who know what's going on know exactly what I'm saying. Maybe I'm adding a few little bits and pieces, It's not like I'm breaking this story or anything. No, I'm adding a little bit of information for you, but the main thing is the conviction to stand up to this, and not be repressed. Not be repressed. That's the important thing. The energy is important. The attitude is important. It's more important than the words, really. The attitude and the energy. The willingness to speak up. You're not alone. You're not alone in this. If you know this stuff, at the higher levels, all of this is known. This is not a secret at all. It's just that everyone's been intimidated. It's obvious what's going on. Totally obvious. It's blatant. Completely blatant. They don't even bother the subterfuge anymore, It's just in your face, blatant. Incredible. And, every time we try to cool down, they orchestrate another shooting, a mass shooting, to pull everybody into the news, right? It's like, oh, we got to pay attention to this. This is really important, and there you go, you're back in paying attention and getting shocked by all this stuff. It's all being orchestrated, it really is, and that these beings are just beneath the surface of consciousness. They're very close. They're able to interface with us very closely. That's apocalypse means the lifting of the veil, and the veil between the etheric and the density we're in here is thinning out, very, very thin. I used to be able to see the etheric realm. And that's why I knew what's going on. I said, hey, I said to the people of this world, you don't know what's going on. You're naive. My gosh, these people here are so naive. And I just looked at who's the most naive and who's the least naive. And from an objective viewpoint, some of the Christians were the least naive people, really. So don't spend your time bashing Christians. I mean, some of them are, they ask for it. But there are a lot that are not so naive at all. I'm telling you that. That is the truth. And they don't so easily fall for the tricks and lies and of the called the devil, or the fallen angels, as it were. They refer to these etheric reptilian parasites as the fallen angels. Not all reptilians are in this condition necessarily, okay? But and not all of them involved in this are necessarily reptilians, okay? There are They're very, there's a whole realm that's very demonic that is simply focused on maintaining their position at all costs, including using us, deceiving us, and using the physical forms here in our energy bodies to milking those and vacuuming off all our energy for their own purposes with no regard for us whatsoever, none. They have the same regard for us as a farmer has for a cow, as milking the cow and then butchering the cow, you know. But that, as far as seeing the cow as an equal, no way, right? You don't see a cow as an equal, at least, well, in India they do. But, in general, we don't see that. But, so these etheric vampires don't see us as having any spirit or their equals or anything like that. They see us as simply something to be used. Slaves. They're slaves. They see us as their slaves. Okay? And we're not their slaves. I'm not their slave. Okay? Neither are you. Neither are you. I'm not anybody's slave. But what they do is they try to get our consent to do what they want. You know, they say, oh, you're not enslaved. You consented to it. Yeah, but they use fakery and trickery and deception and lies and false promises to gain our consent. So it's not true consent. Like I said, they used a double of Anandamayi Ma to gain my consent to work for them, at least partially. But I had my suspicions, okay? And it really didn't amount to much at all. I just wasted my time, basically, and was led down bad roads. But I didn't really help them very much at all. Now, in their eyes, I'm a failure. I really failed. I'm a real bad failure, and I'm being punished for it, you know. This guy's useless. He's worthless. So, you know, what do they have me doing? They have me picking up garbage, you know. That's about all I'm worth to them. It's just nothing. I'll have them, you know, pick up garbage, basically. Consent acquired under lies and deception, and etc., is not consent. Was never consent in the first place. All right, keep that in mind. So you have not consented to be their slave. Nobody has, because it's all under a false pretense. They're offering things they can never deliver. They're writing checks they can't cash. You know, so you are not bound by any consent that you've given them. Any agreement, consent, you are not bound by it at all. Zero. And they tell you that God will not allow you, you know, back into reality if you break your promise, blah, 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 blah. Nonsense. You're already pre-qualified for reality. Reality is your true home. Doesn't matter what kind of promises you make to the contrary, they're not enforceable. Reality doesn't enforce any contracts other than the fact that you are one with reality. You are pre-qualified for reality, unconditionally pre-qualified, unconditionally. It can never be changed, can never be changed in any way. You're already that. Nothing can change it. So the idea that you made some agreement, there's no agreements that are enforceable in existence. None. Forget about agreements, forget about consent, forget about contracts. You're entitled to experience what you really want. You're absolutely entitled to that. And any contract that says otherwise is bogus, was entered into under bogus false promises and false pretenses. You know, the idea that we experience what we want to in existence is a half-truth, because we experience what we think we want, but we're not experiencing what we really want. So the idea that we attract, you know, everything we're experiencing right now is because we wanted it. Half-truth. It's true, but it is not what we really want. We've been tricked into thinking that this is what we want. And so we agreed to it. We agreed to the circumstances that we're in, thinking that it's what we want. But it is never what we really want. No, what we want is reality. The loss-free, zero vulnerability, unbelievably rich and carefree, endless delightfulness of reality. That is what we really want. Anything other than that, we don't want it. And we've deceived ourselves. So It's I don't like the teaching of the idea that you experience what you want at all times. You're experiencing what you want. That's not an escape velocity teaching, in my opinion. Maybe some think that it is. I don't think that it is. I don't believe that it is. You're not experiencing what you really want. You're experiencing what you think you want, and you're attracting that what you think you want, what you led yourself to plausibly believe you want. You don't want loss in any form. I guarantee you don't want it. And yet everything around you, you're surrounded by loss. You don't want any vulnerability, and yet you're surrounded by vulnerability. So it's better, forget about the law of attraction and all that stuff, because whatever you're attracting is not what you really want. You get what you really want by letting existence pass you by, the Passover principle. That's what you get. That's how you get it. Passover principle, and I've explained that. Maybe the next segment I will explain the Passover principle. How to escape this horrible situation that we're in. And if any of you have gone through it, I've gone through it. I'm telling you, it is. They will deplete you of all energy and leave you to die. Literally, that is the truth. And they have no mercy. They don't care. They don't care. And if you agree to do the dirty work for them, you know, they'll supply you with drugs and all of the companionship you want, and whatever that can stimulate you and keep you going, they'll supply whatever you want, you know. And until you completely leave yourself out and OD, basically. So many who have done their bidding have died. So many. So many. Overdosing, suicide, you name it. And just they have, you know, it's so brutal. Brutal, 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 brutal. You think that the people who are on the top, who are super famous, are making all this money and everybody idolizes them, you think their lives are great? Their lives are terrible. The only ones who seem to have a good life are the ones that are simply unconscionable. And maybe I shouldn't need to say their names, but you might know who they are, who just, you know, thrive on being, you know, to pour these psychic steroids into the world, who just seem to, you know, doesn't bother them so much. They tell their kids not to pay any attention to it, but they, there's a few that it doesn't bother very much. But most of us, it bothers us extremely. We don't like it. We don't really like it. We don't like helping these psychic vampires. We don't like helping them. Don't want to help them, and yet they keep telling us, oh, you consented, you have to help us. Yeah, what a bunch of knuckleheads. Really, you didn't consent. Nobody consented. You don't consent except under false promises and false pretexts and lies and deceptions. That's not consent. Not consent. You never consented. Nobody consented. So you're free. You can never consent to attract what you only think you want, because that is not true consent, because you don't really want it. How can it be true consent if you don't really want it? It's deception. It's you've been led to believe that you're going to have something better than what you really want. And of course, we're responsible, because we're the ones who chose the idea of trying to be prime creator and trying to change reality. You know, we're responsible for it. But it's had no effect in reality whatsoever, and we are still 100% children of the Prime Creator, entitled to the entirety of reality. And all the laws, we're entitled to live under the laws of reality, under the rules of reality, under the conditions of reality. We're entirely entitled to that. Everyone is. Even these psychic parasites, vampire reptilians, they're entitled to it as well. You know, they need to realize this, and so they can stop their foolishness. Stop their, you know, this insanity that they seem to be wedded to, that they think they consented to it. You know, no, they didn't. They didn't consent. Nobody's bound by any consent to experience anything other than reality. No one. Never, ever. Okay? So how's that for some prime time stuff? that's the real prime time programming, isn't it? And there it goes. It just froze up at the 1 hour part. Okay. I just have to wait for this to unfreeze. There you go. And is the video gonna come back? Video disappeared. Am I back? I'm back. Okay, that's about an hour. So let's cut this off at an hour, and then I'll do another segment. So instead of watching an hour on the boob tube, you can watch.